The northbound entrance to the Dartford Tunnel, clear by normal standards. On Mothering Sunday, 102,000 cars thundered down under the Thames, nearly double the number the tunnels were built to carry. Soaring above in the early evening gloom, the Dartford Bridge, its two sides nearly joined. When it opens, the four-lane bridge will carry southbound vehicles into Kent. Cars travelling north into Essex will use the tunnels. It should make journeys faster, and the bridge builders want to speed up the toll collection system, so a £2 million French system is to be installed. This is a toll plaza on the main highway between Paris and Deauville in France. It's been fitted with the new AVI, or Automatic Vehicle Identification toll technology. Motorists buy a coded tag, which is mounted on the front windscreen. As the vehicle approaches a toll booth, a radio signal is sent to the tag, which responds with its own code. The information is fed to a computer, which debits the customer's account. The barrier is raised, and all the time the car keeps moving. All 24 toll booths at Dartford will be fitted with the same system.
The fact that three or four lanes of traffic is funneling into two lanes in either direction in the tunnels inevitably means that you've got bottlenecks, and that's what causes the backups in times of peak traffic. Now, we're conscious that once the capacity is increased by the new bridge, that those bottlenecks will be removed, and we certainly don't want to be in the position where we then are responsible for holding up the travelling public.
Motorists that use the tunnels every day are keen to buy the new tags.
If it got me through quicker, I would definitely.
Looking forward to the bridge opening?
I am, yes. As soon as possible. As soon as I get the roadworks out of the way, yes, I will be.
How do you think it will affect your journey to work?
Should hopefully speed it up. At the moment, it's anything between an hour and a half an hour to get through the tunnel in the mornings.
The bridge opens this autumn. By then, the tagging system should be up and running. Motorists that don't use the crossings very often will still be able to pay a toll card or throw loose change into a coin bin. Sally Arthur for Thames News.